We can measure distance and weight. Can we measure information? The answer is yes. Let me show you how with several examples. Information resolves uncertainty. For example, if I told you that there is a gift in the box, this statement is information. Since before I told you, this could be an empty box, and now you know there is a gift inside it. Knowing that information resolves uncertainty gives us a clue to measure it. Let's see an example. I went to see a friend who lives in a hotel at the moment. That hotel has 4 buildings. Each building has 100 rooms. You remember that he told you he lives in the first building. Then the quantity of that piece of information is 1/4. Since it narrowed down to just 1 building, and there are 4 buildings you need to consider before knowing that information. Then he sent you a text message. You can find me on the 10th floor, because it is a 10 storage building. The quantity of that piece of information, 1/10. As you may notice, bigger number means that information is more important. Choose the right answer from A, B, C, and D 4 options. Without any other information, we know each option have a 25% chance to be the right answer. Now, Sam tells you that option A has a 50% chance to be the right answer. How to calculate the amount of information of this piece of information? First, we need to choose a unit to measure information. Just like we can use kilogram to measure weight, use minute to measure time. To measure information, we use bit. The next thing is to define the unit. The bit represents a logic state which with one of 2 possible values. These values are most commonly represented as 1 or 0. Let me introduce you to the formula of the amount of information, where log is the base 2 logarithm, and px is the probability of the event x. By the way, the choice of the base 2 logarithm means that the unit of information measure is in bit. With the unit and formula of information, let's re-examine the question. Choose the right answer from 4 equally possible options. So we need 2 bits information. Sam said option A has a 50% chance to be the right answer. So A 50% to be the right answer amount of information is B, C, and D have a 1/6 chance to be the right answer amount of information is. Now put these numbers together. We get 1.79 bit. So the amount of information Sam gives us is 2 minus 1.79, which is 0.21 bit. You may wonder where the log in the formula comes from. Let's see, you are 70 times of the weight unit, kilogram. Then your weight is 70 kilogram. See, that's a linear relationship. And toss a coin. There will be 2 results. Toss 3 times. How many results you will get? It is not 2 times 3 equals 6, but cube of 2, which is 8 results, right? So they have a logarithm relation. There are 3 doors in front of you, and there is a prize behind one of them. Once you select a door, the host who knows what's behind the doors will open one of the other doors that not have a prize behind it. You will then have the opportunity to switch from the door you originally selected. The question today is not should you switch, but calculate the amount of information the host gave. Post the video if you want to give it a go. In the beginning, you are supposed to select the right door from 3 doors. The information you need is 1.58 bit. After the host opened one door, the information you need to make the right answer is 1 bit. So the amount of information the host gives us is equals to 0.58 bit. 2 takeaways. 1. The bit is a basic unit of information. 2. We can calculate the amount of information using this formula. I'm always here at your service. See you in the next one.